I am rushing to work. My intention was to get to work 30 minutes early so I can finish up some paperwork. But of course, I actually ended up leaving a little bit late in that, you know, there's a chance I could walk into my session a minute or two late. You, I'm not an early riser. I just prayed. I'm just gonna go ahead and read my book. I leave my phone on the other side of the room at night so that I'm not on it at night, and it also keeps me from going to it first thing in the morning, because honestly, when I wake up, I always want to see like what emails do I have, if I have any updates, you know, on social media. I love reading your comments as soon as I get to my phone. But I have noticed that when I get on my phone first thing, it might put me into a bad mood. Try to get a couple things accomplished first before I get to my phone. So I'm reading Maybe You Should Talk to Someone. I do have a video all about the books that I recommend. If you're looking for a book recommendation, go check that video out. I've got more coming. In today's video, you'll see that I am back at work twice a week now, but all of my clients are still virtual. You'll just see what my routine looks like on the days that I do have to leave the house. If you've seen a few of my other videos, you know that I start seeing clients in the afternoon through the evening most of the time. So I have the morning to do other things. And so this morning, we're gonna go ahead and do a hike. We do this hike probably about 2 to 3 times a week, if not more. I need to clean the kitchen. Then of course I'm gonna go to work and share with you guys about some of the paperwork I'm working on right now, as well as some of the cases that I'm working on. So stay tuned to see what I do throughout the day. One, this is our few lemon seeds that I planted, and it looks so crazy, like, to see them coming out. All right, you guys, so our kitchen is a huge mess. Our arrangement now, as of the last few weeks, is that my husband cooks and I clean the kitchen, and I haven't been cleaning the kitchen like I should. And so for the last 2 days, it has looked like this. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean it this morning. Ignore the huge watermelon that we need to cut, but this is a lot better. This is when I will go ahead and grab my phone for the first time and check my notifications while I eat. All right, so we are headed to our favorite little hiking spot. It's a very easy hike, 30-minute workout. And we've got Indelcy driving.
Hey.
And I will show you a little bit of the hike once we're there. Take a break and read at the top, and then we go back down. It was so blazing. Look at that tan. That is from today. I'm going to start getting ready for work. Gotta do my hair. Gotta do my makeup, which I'm not gonna do a ton of makeup. I usually A lot of times I don't put on any, but because I'm doing this video, I'm gonna go ahead and put on something and then we'll be on our way to the office. All right, makeup's done, just something light. And now I'm gonna go ahead and get dressed and run out of here. All right, so I am now ready for work. This is the look for the day, just a dress and some heels. So I gotta pack my lunch. And honestly, I just bring a frozen dinner and some fruit usually. And I'm gonna get a couple of bites of watermelon before I leave. All right, let's go. All right, so I am rushing to work. My intention was to get to work 30 minutes early so I can finish up some paperwork for a new client that I met yesterday. But of course, I actually ended up leaving a little bit late in that, you know, there's a chance I could walk into my session a minute or two late. So yeah, gotta work on that. I still have room to grow, guys. So it actually looks like I'm gonna make it with some time to spare. I'm not gonna tell you guys how I made that happen. Just use your deductive reasoning skills. All right, here just in time. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my laptop. Even though I'm in the office, you'll see that all of my clients are still virtual. I asked you guys on Instagram if you would be interested in that, since it's gonna be kind of similar to when I did my last day in life and everybody said yes. Hopefully this gives you a little bit of insight as to where I am now as far as seeing clients amid the pandemic while being back in the office. My first client today is an adult client who is struggling with motivation. So we'll be focusing on building motivation and unpacking the things that are getting in their way of being as productive as they want to be. All right, so my first session is done for the day. And so what therapists do in between sessions, we usually use the restroom, maybe get a snack. And so I'm gonna try to do both of those things. Give you guys a little update. I have 5 clients today, 4 adults and 1 child. One of my sessions today, if you see clients with Medicaid, there's a lot of paperwork and a lot of different types of meetings that you have to have. So today it's time for me to get another diagnostic verification for my client because I am associate licensed. With some insurance panels, I cannot practice on those insurance panels. And with some insurance like Medicaid, I can practice, but there still needs to be a fully licensed therapist who verifies the diagnosis that I give my clients. So I'm about to do a collaborative session where another therapist is going to join in my session today. This is like the quickest way to get these done. And they'll just join for probably 15, 20 minutes, verify the diagnosis that I have on the chart, or maybe consider a diagnosis that I hadn't considered. And then my client will be able to continue having their services provided to them for free. I love cheese. Now, I'm telling you guys, the minutes between those sessions are critical. I still have 8 minutes, and so I'm going to use that time to finish up my note for the client that I just saw. But also, I have a new client that I saw yesterday that I still have some more paperwork to finish for that client. And so I'm gonna go back and try to get some of this paperwork done.
So being a therapist, a lot of times it's all about multitasking and being able to make efficient use of your time, especially if you're like me and you don't like to get off work and still have work to do. I try to have my snack, do some work, drink water, use the restroom, all in that 15-minute break. So that's why it's really important to end your sessions on time so that you can better manage your day. The first thing I need to do for this client that I'm finishing up paperwork for is look at the schedules of the fully licensed therapist and see who's available to do their diagnostic verification as soon as possible. All right, so I found somebody that could possibly do this diagnostic verification. So now I have more paperwork to finish, but my other session is gonna start in 2 minutes, so I won't really have time. But that just gives you guys a little bit of insight into how we use those 15 minutes in between sessions. I know a lot of clients wish that they were a full hour, but it's hard when your sessions are a full hour and you're back to back and you have no wiggle room for, first of all, if you need a couple of minutes to help a client decompress, but then also when you need to do like paperwork and things like that. So now I am waiting for the second therapist and my client so that we can have this joint session for a diagnostic verification. All right, so I just finished that session with the second therapist for diagnostic verification. She actually had different clinical impressions for the client, and it kind of was just a testament to the progress that this client has made over the past year, that the diagnosis that she originally had really no longer stands, and we moved it to two less severe diagnoses. So that's actually great news. Got that updated in the chart, and now I'm gonna have another snack and try to work on some paperwork in between sessions. My next client is a client that I meet with monthly, and we are just in a process of just kind of regular maintenance. They work through the issues that they were originally presenting for in therapy, and now they just kind of come to unpack anything that's happened to them in the past month. All right, so I am waiting on a client. Whenever I am waiting on a client, I usually do one of three things. I either get on my phone, I will read, or I'll do a Sudoku puzzle. So I'm gonna read. I'm just trying to finish this book. I have other books that I need to get to, so I'm putting in all my extra time to try to finish. All right, it is time for like my lunch, dinner. I guess it is like 5 o'clock, but I'm gonna have real dinner when I get home. I'm gonna go ahead and warm this up. I've got 6 minutes to eat. All right, so I just finished a session with a child. We talked about bullying, we talked about depression, and we engaged in a bit of play therapy with my kids. A lot of times what they really respond well to are like games where they get to learn about me and I can learn about them too, instead of it feeling like an interview or interrogation. So there's an app on Zoom. Zoom has apps now called Ask Away. So it was asking random questions and we would just both answer questions like, do we play any sports? What is our pet peeve? Those kind of things. And I do those kind of questions, especially with my kid clients, because it just helps them not see me as just another authority figure. It humanizes the therapist, and I think it gets rid of some of that authority that inevitably comes with the child and adult. So we were able to talk about a lot of important stuff and also have some fun. So that was a fun session. I have one more session today, and then I get to go home to my husband. This is the part of the day where I really could use a second cup of coffee. But if I drink coffee at 6 p.m., I'm not gonna be able to sleep. So I just gotta push through. All right, guys, so that is our final session of the day. Y'all, I am like so tired and so excited to go home and eat dinner, just relax for the rest of the night. I'll show you guys a little bit of dinner and then we'll be done vlogging for the day. All right, we're finally leaving. I feel like every time I leave at this time, it should be dark outside, but it's still completely light. Finally headed home to Ndosi in the comfort of my bed. All right, guys, I made it home safely. This guy cooking dinner. We're about to eat. We got Brussels sprouts and meatballs. I'm about to eat and probably catch a show. Then I'm going to get in bed after I take my shower and probably a bath. I ask that you like this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. Click on bell notification so you know every time I upload. Share this with a friend if you've got anybody who's curious about what a day in the life would look like for a therapist. If you like these kind of videos, make sure to let me know so that I can be sure to do more of them. I'm just answering your requests. Thank you to everyone who's been requesting more day in the life videos. I appreciate you watching until the end. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye. You'll say bye, babe.
Oh, bye.